The river height for the Hawkesbury remains at a major flood level as we go to air tonight. 10 News First has been out on the water with our state emergency service as crews continue to check in those communities still cut off. Others have been able to return home, starting on the long road to recovery.
Homes and livelihoods have disappeared in the depths of the Hawkesbury River. It's impossible to tell where roads run, metres below the murky water. It's only homes with multiple stories that can be seen. The river has risen higher this flood event than last, catching some people off guard.
Well, the house over behind us, the other day they had a couple of people that were standing on the veranda that actually waved SES in to come and transport them back to dry land. And yesterday when we're coming back through here, towards the peak, the water level had risen from the first floor that they were standing on up to the roof line of the existing house there.
But the SES has still had to do less rescues from homes along the Hawkesbury this time round. Residents seem more prepared as they sadly become used to their homes being swallowed by the river.
People have obviously had the practice now and being a lot more prepared and ready for it.
Right now, it's impossible to tell what's left under all this water. The Hawkesbury River is slowly receding. It's expected to dip below the major flooding level tomorrow. And so begins the next stage of this disaster as residents start returning to their homes. Those who can now access their properties move room to room of their homes, surveying the damage and starting the cleanup.
You know, waist deep walking out through the front too, so I had to carry the dogs out and, yeah.
Stephen has only lived here for 12 months, but this is the third flood he's endured in that time. Somehow he, like many of the residents here on the Hawkesbury, must keep finding the strength to roll up their sleeves and keep going.
Just, you got to do it. There's nothing else you can do. Just hope for the best and hope we don't get another one in 3.5 months.
Starting again, these residents can only hope it will be for the last time. The floodwaters are very slowly starting to recede here on the Hawkesbury River at Windsor. They've dropped about a metre in the past 24 hours as they recede. Some residents have been able to return home, but that's when they've told me that the real difficult part of dealing with this disaster begins as they start the cleanup. They've been ripping up floors, cleaning walls and throwing out furniture. Already it's a long road to recovery that unfortunately they've done many times before.
Indeed, Samara, thank you.